MVVM, Model View View Model, is often hailed as the go-to architecture in SwiftUI development thanks to its clear separation of concerns and reactive data binding with SwiftUI state management. However, it can become overly complex, leading to bloated view models and unclear boundaries. That's why, in this video, I introduce you to MVSU, Model View Service Utility, a simplified yet powerful alternative tailored for SwiftUI. You'll get a step-by-step example of how to implement MVSU, showing you exactly what to use and how it streamlines your app architecture while keeping your code modular and maintainable. MVVM is everywhere, but it's not for all use cases when you are building SwiftUI apps. Today, I am going to show you what to do instead. MVVM is fine for a small project, but when you are building out a large-scale project, they need to be scalable, you need something else. If you like these type of tutorials, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions, rebeloper.com/mentoring, escape tutorial here, and ask a senior iOS developer whether you have a bug in your code or you want to learn SwiftUI. Go ahead and check it out. The link is down in the description. So today we are going to talk about MVVM and why it's good and why it's not so good and what to do instead. So let's start off by learning about MVVM. What is MVVM? Model View View Model. Let's create our model first. Let's create a new empty file and let's name this profile. And let's import SwiftUI. And I'm going to make it as simple as possible. I'm going to have not a view, but a simple struct called profile. And I'm going to have a name of type string. Easy as it is. Just for convenience, I'm going to create an initializer that has a default value for the name, an empty string. You will see later on when I'm going to use this. So this is our model, MVVM, model view. Now the view is the content view. It's really nice. We are going to use our profile right over here. What is the last part? View model. Well, you have to create a view model for your views. And this is very, very important to notice about MVVM. It's the view model for the particular view. So here we have our content view. We are going to create a content view model. If we have a destination view, then we would create a destination view model. Each view model is specifically created for that view. No moving around, no sharing data. That's kind of the drawback right over here. So let's just scale it back a little bit. Let's create our content view model because this view model needs to be accessed only by this particular view, the content view. I'm just going to create it as an extension on the content view. There we go. And let this be a class. And this will be our view model. There we go. I'm going to use the observation framework, so let's add in here at observable. Okay, so we have our view model. How can we access it? Well, it couldn't be simpler. We are just going to have at state private var view model of type view model and just initialize it as view model. Okay. Of course, we need that profile to be available on our view model. Let's just scroll a little bit down and have a profile. And yeah, you could just have it as an optional, but then when you are actually linking it to your views, then you always have to unwrap it, which is really annoying to do and tedious. Instead, I would just prefer to just give it a default value, so profile. And as you can see, we have two initializers. One, the internal initializer that was created by the struct. And then we have this one, which actually uses the custom initializer that we created, which gives the name an empty string. So this is why I just create these custom initializers with those initial values, in my case, the empty string for the name. Okay, so we have the profile. This is the data handling. It's inside the view model. Let's have some logic. So I'm going to create a function called change name. There we go. So right over here, I'm just going to say profile.name equals Alex. That's fine. Okay, so now we are going to use this inside our view. We already have access to our view model through the state variable. Now, let's remove the image. I don't really care about the image. I'm going to have a text of hello and then viewmodel.profile.name. Okay. And then I'm going to have a button. So let's have this button. I've changed name. That's right. This is really nice. ViewModel.changeName. Let's see if we can have a look inside our preview provider. It should go seamlessly. Let's just wait for that. And if I tap on change name, there we go. Alex has been populated. Really simple. MVVM at its core and at its best. Having a SwiftUI mentor can elevate your developer status by providing personalized guidance, helping you overcome challenges faster, and offering insights that only come with experience. A mentor accelerates your learning curve, ensures you stay up to date with the latest best practices, and helps you build a strong portfolio that stands out in the competitive iOS development world. By joining my mentoring sessions, you'll gain tailored advice, hands-on support, and actionable feedback to master SwiftUI and confidently take your skills and career to the next level. The link is down in the description. As you can see, this is encapsulated. This is really nice. Separation of concerns. It ticks a lot of boxes. But you can't actually use this to share data between your views. So for example, I would like the profile to be, you know, available on other views too. So there are two ways of doing this. One would be like passing along the view model, which is again a no-no because view models should be, you know, just for this particular view. Or you could make this as an environment object. So yes, that is what we are going to do. Of course, not this particular one, not the view model. We are going to create a separate observable that will be available throughout our application. Okay, let's just create a new file. And I'm just going to call this a service. So let's just call this app service. There we go. And again, I'm going to copy out this code, observable class, because all the functionality is basically the same. I want this profile and the change name to be available throughout my application. So let's rename to app service, and that's it. Now I need to make this available throughout my app. First of all, let's import SwiftUI, so the observable macro will be accessible. There we go. Now let's go to the app file and let's create our service. So at state private var, and this will be an app service of type app service equals app service. Okay, this is the source of truth. Now we need to distribute it on our views. We are going to do that with the environment, not the environment object, but the environment view modifier. And I'm just going to pass it along as app service. Now the app service will be available throughout my application because, you know, the content view is the first view that I'm loading it into. So now I can just safely, I'm going to comment it out. If you need like really content view specific data logic and data handling, then you could use a view model. That's fine. But it's rare. It's really rare to do so. So now we need to access our app service. It's as easy as at environment. And then you would just say app service dot self private var app service. There we go. Really, really nice. Okay, so now let's grab app service and say app service dot profile dot name and app service dot change name. Okay. One thing that I would like to add in here, because it's not that obvious and you will get into trouble if you don't do it. Let's have a binding on that name. So a text field, name, and the text would be, $appservice.profile.name. But now we're going to have an issue right over here. And it says, cannot find $appservice. What? It's already over here. Well, we need to make the environment bindable. So let's do that. You have to add this into your body. So at bindable var app service equals app service. And now the binding will just simply go through. There we go. Now we have access to the app services buckets of profile and the name, and we can bind the app service with the dollar sign as you might expect it to. Okay, so this is really nice, but there's one last component that I want to talk about. Currently we have model view service, so MVS, but there's another one, utility. Now let's go back to the app service. You see here we have the change name, and then I just set up the profile.name to be Alex. Okay, that's fine, but usually you want to fetch this from some sort of a backend with an API, and for that you want to have this in a separate, different, you know, structure, and it's called in my naming a utility, because otherwise you would just need to write out over and over and over again the fetches inside your app service, the observable, and this will scale a lot. And let's just create this as a separate file. So we have the model, we have the view, we have the service. Now we are going to create a utility. So let's create a new empty file. Let's call this API utility. There we go, API utility. This will be a simple struct, API utility, there we go. And we are going to create here static functions. So static func, and let's say fetch name. And this will return a string, and I'm just going to return Alex right over here. It's just simple, but we are going to connect to the database and all that. Great. Now we go back to our app service, and instead of saying profile.name equals Alex, I'm going to access my API service, API utility, sorry, and then call fetch name on it. Dot fetch name, because this is a static function, you can just call it with a dot notation. And that's it. Now it's much easier. All of the logic, like fetching the name, is inside the utility, and all of the stuff, you know, posting, fetching, updating, deleting, can be done inside these utilities. Now, what is the difference between, besides just moving all of the logic into its separate particular destinated utility? Well, as you can see here, we don't have the actual data stored. These are just actions, functions that you can run. The actual data storage is inside the observable app service. You see, we have the profile right over here. We're just calling upon these, you know, functionalities, functions, do this, do that, and then give me back the name or whatever that function is all about. So that is the difference between the service and the utility. And this way, you can structure your code in a logical way, really, really nicely. You have the model, you have the view, you have the service, and then you have the utility. That's it, MVSU. It's better than MVVM. I hope you enjoy this. And if you do like these type of tutorials, go ahead and check out the mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.